AI-generated images have opened new doors for creativity, allowing us to explore visual realms beyond our wildest imaginations. So let's leave Earth and explore deep space and learn how to create this scene. The prompt for our mission is an astronaut from the back, standing in front of a space nebula portal with planets and cosmoses. Here are a few results that I've generated using DALL-E, Firefly, Leonardo, and Midjourney, which to my opinion excelled in this task. So I ended up with these three options. And comparing all of the results I got, I decided to go with this one. Now, I just want to show you a few automated options that I've used in other AI engines that are capable of generating video from images. Here is the result from Leonardo AI Motion option. And this looks impressive, doesn't it? This one is from Pika Labs, which also looks nice, but a bit too fast to my taste. And here's what I consider to be the best of them all from Runaway Gen 2. Now, the cons with AI video at the time of this recording is that the longer the video is, the softer and muddier it will look. You have a little control of the animation and consistency, and quite limited options for telling your story, which, to my opinion, is the most important thing. For example, in this case, I wanted to change the big planet in the center for something else that will make more sense. Maybe a light bulb with energy stripes that puzzle our astronaut hero. Now, this is something which currently isn't possible with any of the AI video generation tools that I showed you. So now that I've established the why, let's see the how. So before opening the image in Photoshop and prepare it for animation by splitting the layers, I need to upscale this image. Now, my weapon of choice is Topaz Photo AI, and this is a paid tool and not the cheapest around, but it's one-time purchase and I think it will justify itself quickly. However, I do understand that not everyone can purchase it, and to help you with that, I recommend a free upscale app called Upscaly with Y at the end. Now, you can get it at this address. All the links are listed down below. So whatever tool you're using, make sure to upscale the AI image, and now we can bring it into Photoshop and prepare the layers for animation. And to save some time, I'll walk you through this process so we can get to the animation stage ASAP. So you can see that I have three generative fill layers that hides the astronaut and the planet. I isolated the astronaut, of course, and jumped him to a separated layer. This way, I can animate it separately inside After Effects. Now, my plan is to move the camera slowly towards the astronaut, adding some glowing energy light bulbs in front of him, and finally make him react to what he sees. And to help with this and introduce the star of this tutorial, I'll use a machine learning tool to convert the background to a 3D model. This way, it will look more realistic and we can enjoy some 3D parallax, as well as place elements in 3D space based on the depth of the scene. So, to do this, we'll need to export a clean background plate as a JPEG file. I'll do it quickly here from Photoshop. And once I have the file, I can switch to my web browser and go to the ZoeDepth website, which is a deep learning model for metric depth estimation from a single image. Here, I can choose the second tab, Image to 3D, and then upload the clean background that I've just exported from Photoshop. I'll make sure to tick Keep Occlusion Edges and then submit the job. Now, this is going to take a few moments depending on the server load. And once it's finished, I can download this 3D model as a GLB file. Now, don't worry about the washed out colors that you are seeing here. It will look correct once we'll import it to After Effects. In After Effects, I'll import the files that I've prepared. I'll double click inside the project panel. I'll select first the space.glb. This is the model that I've just created from the ZoeDepth website. And then I'm also going to command click on this Adobe Stock clip, which is a free video that you can also license yourself if you want. And I have additional two smoke wisp clips. I'm also going to bring this sound that I'll use later, as well as this space PSD. So I'll click open. And actually from the space PSD, I only need the astronaut layer. So I'll delete it. I'll double click again and I'll select the file, click open. And this way I can select just footage, and under choose layer, I'll make sure that I'll bring just the astronaut using its layer size. And now I can click OK. So now we are ready to create the composition and merge all the layers as well as animate them. I'll start, of course, with the 3D model. So I'll grab the space.glb, drag and drop it, and create a comp out of it. I'll click on Make Comp Size to scale the image to the comp dimensions. And I'm also going to add additional kind of scale. Now you can see that it's actually flipped. So what we need to do is visit the advanced options here and check flip Z axis. And this should fix it. Almost, it's still mirrored, but again, this is an easy fix. So what I'll do right now is just scale it until it's basically touching the edges of this comp. So let's just round it to 500, and finally I'll click OK. Now to flip this file, I'll go to the scale options in the properties panel. I'll disconnect the constraint proportion icon, meaning that I can just plug in negative 100, and this is going to fix this one. We can also use the 3D gizmo and bring it just a touch down. You can already see how this is going to work for us. Now, a bit of a housekeeping before I'll show you what we can do. I'll grab this Space 2 comp, place it outside, and I'm actually going to rename it Spaceman. And while we are here, let's select this Spaceman comp, go to the composition settings, and change it to 25 frames per second. And I don't think I need more than 8 seconds in terms of its duration. I'm happy, so I'll click OK. And now, if I'll press C to enable the camera tools, I can orbit around this model, and we can see that indeed, we can animate the camera. So this looks really promising. What I'll do right now is go to the layer menu, and under new, I'll create a new camera. I'll select a 50 millimeter camera and click OK. I'll switch to Draft 3D so I can work quicker. And then I'll press 3 to enable the dolly tool. At the beginning, I'll push into this, maybe from this position until I'm happy with the framing. So something like this. And then I'll create keyframes for the point of interest as well as the position. Then I'll go all the way to the end and I'll continue to push inside this image. So we can push as much as we want, but we need to be careful with the orbit tool. Let me show you what I mean. If I'll press 1 and start to orbit the scene, we can see this 3D model is going to break apart quickly due to the fact that this is basically a projection on top of this 3D depth. So just be mindful of that. But I think that this nice push is going to be enough to sell the scene. I'm also going to select both sets of keyframes and press F9 to create some smoothing to the keyframes. So easy ease at the beginning and at the end. And I think this is a good starting point. We can always go back to the end and then switch tools and maybe reframe the shot. So we'll have more of this upper planet. Something like this, I think, will look nice. And then due to the fact that we are using Draft 3D, we can just press spacebar and animate it, or actually see the preview in real time. All right, so we're probably going to mess with it and change our minds, but for now, this is good enough. The next thing is to add the other elements and place them in 3D space to create the 3D interaction. So I'll start with the astronaut. I'll drag and drop it under the camera. We can close the camera, by the way, and then convert it to 3D. So now this is a flat 3D card in space. I'll press P to see the position. I'll hold down Shift and I'll start to drag to the right to move the astronaut so he will be more or less where I want him to be. Now this is kind of a guessing game, so I have a bit of experience with this file. I know that a good starting point for the Z value should be 7000. And then it means that I'll need to press S or go to the properties panel and compensate by scaling this guy a bit up. Now I can place him more or less where he was, and you can see it is nicely intersecting with the rest of the layers. And again, just to illustrate how this looks, I'll press C to enable the camera tools. I'll need to press C again, two times in my case, because I want to return to the orbit tool and show you that indeed we have a really impressive 3D scene, but we need to be careful how we are animating it. All right, I'll undo this last modification and I'm going to add the Adobe stock clip. So I'll do more or less the same thing. I'll drag and drop it over here and then I'll make it 3D layer. I'll press P to see its position values and I'm going to take it, let's go with 10,000 to begin with. So it will be in front of the astronaut. And I'll press Shift S to see the scale and scale it back to, let's go with 400. And you can see that it is encapsulated between those two layers. Now, unfortunately, we can't access blending modes using the advanced 3D renderer. So we'll need to find a way to say goodbye to the dark pixels here. And we can do it using effects. So I'll click on the effects and presets panel to see it. And here in the search field, I'll type unmult. And there is a built-in preset, alpha from lightness, in parentheses, unmult. Double click to apply it. And basically, this is it. Now, if you want, you can play with take alpha from instead of lightness. You can change it to luminous, which is going to give you a different result, a brighter result in this case. I'll leave it at lightness for this instance. And as we can see, this already looks really promising. And of course, we can still move it in 3D space. So I actually want it to be over here. So it will just touch the edge of the planet. And I think I can do it a little bit more gently from the timeline. So this is what I'm looking for in this case. Again, the numbers doesn't really matter. The important thing is that we have a 3D unified world. All right, we can also add additional effects. So let's go with color correction and add the HLS color balance. And now I can change the hue to something different. So let's go with 60, which looks a little bit more in line with the background colors. And now we can duplicate this clip. So I'll press Command D and we can change its Z rotation. So it will look different. So let's go with 180, as well as change the color balance effect. We can basically just take it off and maybe also change the shift channel, take alpha from to luminance. And of course, we can also change the opacity to, let's say, 50%. So now we have two versions, one on top of the other, and it looks very promising. And now we can animate the astronaut. And I'll do it using the puppet pin tools. So I'll go to the beginning, select the astronaut layer. I'll click on the puppet position pin, and I'll create pins over here at strategic places on top of his hands, maybe on top of his legs. One over here, one over here. I only want to animate the hands. So I can now go to the end, and since the puppet pin already created keyframes for me, I can start moving his right hand, the left for us, and maybe also bring his elbow a little bit more closer, as well as this hand. Now there is a little bit of a problem over here with this one. Let me just zoom in so you can see what I'm talking about. This hand is not going behind the body. And I think that this also intersects with the suit. So to remedy this, what we need to do is switch to the puppet overlap pin tool. And this will help us to create two additional pins that will allow us to extend it. So this tells the tool how many triangles it needs to take under consideration. So I'll create one for this hand, another one at the opposite side with the same extent value. And I need to change each one of them for a negative value. So negative 50 should work for this guy. I'll click over here and set the in front to negative 50 for the other hand. And now the hands are going to go to the correct position. All right, let's zoom out and we can close this layer. return back to the selection tool. And now that I look at it, I want to reframe the shot. So I'll return back to the camera, making sure I'm on the last keyframe, and I'll click and move the entire scene. So we'll see more of this astronaut guy. And this is also going to give me an opportunity to add some atmosphere in the shape of two smoke wisps underneath, or actually behind and in front of him. So I'll go back to the beginning, return to the project panel. Let's start with smoke wisp number 9. I'll drag and drop it to the comp. First, I want to show it to you. So double click to play it in the layer viewer. So this is one version, and I have another one which looks like this. All right, so I'll close both of them, return back to the comp. I'll need to convert this layer to 3D so it will interact with all the other layers. And I'll press P to show the position. Hold down Shift and start to drag it until it will intersect with the layers here. So I actually need to drag it quite far away. All right, I want this one to be in front of him. So I guess 6,200. I'll press Shift S to see the scale, and I'll scale it. And as you can see, this is placing itself in front of the astronaut, but behind those rocks. Now, it's a bit too harsh. Again, the quality of the 3D model is not the best in the world, so we'll need to mask it to hide the edges. I'll switch to the rectangle mask, and then I'll draw the mask over here. Press F to show the feather, and then I'll smooth the layer borders by changing the mask feather. And if I'll play it, you can see how this works. So we have some smoke going on from underneath. And of course, this is still 3D card in space. So I can select it and maybe move it a touch down. I think it will make more sense if it will be, I guess, somewhere over here. So totally up to you. But for me, it looks quite nice. I'll duplicate the same layer by pressing Command D, and then I'll swap it with the other version of the smoke. So holding down the Option key, I'll drag and drop to the comp. Now I have another version. I'll press P, and this one wants to be in front of the astronaut, so I'll just change its position. And maybe I need to also change the feathering, or I can just bring it a bit more higher, something like this, maybe to the right, so I won't see this hard edge. Let's go to the beginning, press spacebar and see how this works. I think it adds additional atmosphere to the shot, and I dig it. So the last thing that I want to do right now, switch off Draft 3D, then take the space ambient voyage that I've created, place it underneath, maximize the frame by pressing on the tilde key, and preview the result. So, what do you think? I'll argue that this Taylor handmade comp looks better than the automated AI tools that I showed you at the outset of this video. It looks a bit more professional and has consistency and higher resolution, and most importantly, I think it has more soul to it. Now, if you're intrigued by artificial intelligence and eager to discover how it can enhance your efficiency and creativity, I want to invite you to explore my live training workshops in collaboration with FMC and NAB Show. I'm teaching two virtual courses, AI Design, the Future of Image Creation, and AI VFX and Motion, Crafting Visual Wonders with AI. Each course is a 3-hour long hands-on training with exercise files and certification exams if you want to take it. Registration is now open, and for a limited time, you can avail a special discount with the coupon code that you're seeing on screen. So this is it for this one. I hope we can meet in this training or in the next tutorial. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you again soon.